Across the U.S. and around the world, demonstrators have taken to the streets to protest the killing of George Floyd, an unarmed African American, at the hands of Minneapolis police. And now, more cases of blacks and Latinos dying during police interactions are entering the spotlight. In March, Breonna Taylor, a paramedic in Louisville, Kentucky, was gunned down by police as they executed a no-knock, drug-related search warrant at her home. Police say they only fired after her boyfriend shot at them. He says he fired in self-defense, fearing the police were intruders. No officers have been charged, the FBI is investigating, and the Taylor family is suing the police.
Louisville Metropolitan Police Department, there is absolutely no reason Breonna Taylor should be dead, killed in a hail of bullets from your police officers.
Also in March, Manuel Ellis, an African-American man in Tacoma, Washington, died as police restrained him. No officers have been charged. The state is investigating. Last year in Austin, Texas, Javier Ambler was pulled over by county sheriffs for not dimming his headlights. A chase ensued, and deputies used a move sometimes called a chokehold. He can be heard crying, "I can't breathe," before he died, words later echoed by George Floyd. No charges have been filed, but prosecutors say they plan to present a case to a grand jury. And in Las Cruces, New Mexico, in February, Antonio Valenzuela died after police chased him down and used a taser and a neck restraint. The officer in that case has been charged with manslaughter.
These cases and others are leading to calls for large-scale police reform in the United States.
I'll tell you, this is a historic moment, a necessary moment. We have been waiting for a time like this when people would finally wrap their attention around the injustices that have been impacting and afflicting the Black community for far too long.
And as police reform becomes a priority, some communities are taking steps many say are long overdue, removing statues meant to honor Civil War figures, symbols of slavery that critics say have no place in modern America. Jim Spellman, CGTN, Bethesda, Maryland.